Hello everybody. Today I'm going to do a little video on some notches. I know that a lot of people have been seeing, wanting to go out and do things, make traps, things like that. Well, they had a thing when I was getting taught, when I first started, called a notch stick. And you practice your notches on making one stick full of just different kinds of notches, using the tools you usually have on you. Now, I carry, you might carry something different. I've got a Mora. My folding saw, Baco, and a Swiss Champ. So, them are the knives I usually carry in. My kit are on me. And the saw that I usually carry. So what I've done is just grabbed a piece of scrap lumber. Nothing special, fancy. And we're going to go over about, I don't know, five or six or more carvings. Okay? So, glad you guys could join us. Let's get started. First thing we're going to do is you learn to peel off all your stuff. All the bark. Okay? That's what we're going to do today. We'll have a few knots in it. You know, never find a perfect piece of wood for projects, but you want to get the majority of your bark off of your stick. And what this will do is give you the ability to see what you're going to be carving out. Yeah, overlooked the background noise. Said I'd just come out here in the yard and knock some stuff out and kind of show you guys that you don't have to be in the darkest, deepest woods and 20 miles away from everything to practice any skill. I've sat and wove rope on the couch watching a TV program before. So, anywhere and everywhere. And this don't have to be perfect. Unless you want it to be. I'm just getting off the bark so we can see what kind of wood we got. So, there's what we've got so far. Okay. Nothing big, nothing fancy. Now, I'm going to use basically these two tools. And I'm going to start out with making, we'll make this into a giant, pretty good size stake for like your tent or your tarp. So that's going to be pretty simple, but you're going to notch one end down, you're going to make a point on it. While you're carving it out, if you want to do anything round, you just spin it a little at a time, and that way you're catching an edge each time, which is what you can probably see me doing here. I can get the camera angle up. And you just keep spinning it until you get down to an edge. If not, what you're going to do is you're going to get a wedge. So like you just sharpen one side down constantly. You won't get nothing even near round. It'll be pretty much just a wedge shape. Which I'm not saying won't work. Which is not easy to do. But this is a lot stronger. Because you're going to have more body. Versus just wedging off the end of it. But then when you get down to the edge, or the tip, start pulling it down to where you're not taking off big chunks. You're spinning it and rolling it at the same time. Hope you guys are seeing that. See that right there? Now you made a stake out of it at one end. There you go. Now on the other end, because you're going to hammer on it, keep that in mind, you're going to drive down on this. If you leave it flat like this, what's going to happen is it's going to split it either side. Start cracking, warping. So what you're going to do is you're going to put a taper on it. You can use your thumb. Put it on, push forward with this hand, and push with your thumb to guide it. Now remember, all this is for training. So when you get out, this is what you naturally do. But fine carving, you'll be using a lot on your thumb, okay? Something stuck underneath that one, grabbing junk out. But you're gonna roll over this edge. So that way, it won't split out on you. See that? Nothing perfect, nothing, you know. It's got to be this way or that way. Now, when you hammer on that, it'll want to mushroom out. And this will stop it from splitting as bad. I'm not saying if you nail down on this and hit something hard on this end. But you've got yourself a good stake right there. And that would be your first carving set. It's just a simple tent peg, tarp stake. Now, next thing we're going to make, which is a little different, it's going to be what they call a log cabin notch. Now, what I like about having two different tools to do it with, you can do everything with this. You do the same thing with the multi-tools, like the Leatherman 3000 or Super Tool or whatever you want to call them. This has a nice saw on it. Works pretty good. It's got a pretty good sharp blade on it. So, but all the a cabin notch is we'll be taking the wood and actually making a square notch out of it. Just like you would when you're going to build a cabin on a Lincoln log set when you were a kid, that same cutout. So what I like to do is I just take my saw and pick a side. And what this does is gives you the ability to make a nice straight cut and put it in fairly deep so you can square everything up on it. All right. But this is going to be used, so if you want to put two things together, then lash them so that way they stay together. See, pretty good thing. Now I know a lot of people are going to ask, if I don't have that and all I have is a knife and let's say this Baco, yes, you can do it with that. And I'll show you, all you do is do the same thing. That Baco cuts a little better than that, of course. But now this is what I'm doing, is just relief cutting it. So that way I don't have as much to bring out. Everything's nice and square and equal. See how I've cut every one of these? Equal in depth. Now they're not going to be so hard to get out. Yeah. See, I could have done that, and then what I would have done if all I had was this and a knife is I would have sawed down, and then in about the middle I would have sawed down to an angle, so I would have cut out an angle this way and cut out an angle this direction, and then I could have chopped out the center. But right now we'll just go in here with my regular knife, dig in at an angle like you see me doing here, and it should pop off because they're so small, and I'm cutting in. Now, don't get me wrong, don't stick it in here and pry, because the knife's not meant for prying. If you had your bigger knife, like you could get the more out, I could get in here, put it in because of its size, and bend and break a tab out, just like that. I could do the same thing to the other side. See that? So with the big knife, you can do both. Now granted, your inside is going to be kind of tight when you're using the knife, but it is possible to do with the two bigger tools. The reason I like the smaller tools is you can get in a little bit easier into the edges. So when it's time to do that fine cutting and that actual leveling out, see, I'm only using that much of it. Is it working? Yes. I can do it that way. Yes. But it's got some limitations because of its size. If I've got this knife, I can stick it all the way in. See that? So I can sit here, get everything down, run the blade back and forth to really smooth out that cut. Now, I don't know if you can see it on the camera. Take a look at that cut. I sit here and take my time and smooth it out, and you can see it didn't take that long to really knock that out. Now, I know some people want to make a chair, make a lot of different stuff with this notch, then notch another piece and sit down inside of it. Then you can lash it, and that's going to give that a lot of rigidity. So, but that is what they call a cabin notch. Next notch I'm going to do is a stake notch, which if you were going to use this as just a stake, a tent peg or a stake, you'd want something to be able to wrap it around. So you can do the same thing again. You can pull your saw out. And you make a notch in it. Now, I'm going to use this just because this thing's a monster. It's, you know, it works, but it's up there. And I want to show everybody that you can do it with just a pocket tool. But if this was a stake and I was going to drive it down, put it about an inch, which it should be about an inch, tip your finger to the bend, but about an inch down, and just cut a nice straight line across. Okay. Try to keep it as straight as you can. Make it in about a quarter or so of the way. Now, what we'll do is we'll take our knife and that same cut. We'll use that same thumb assist and we'll start digging it out. See that? And then that chunk of wood, remember, don't force stroke it. If you force stroke it, you will split this. Because it is, you do have a sharp blade and you're putting force behind it, so it ain't no different than when we carved this end. But if you keep a little at a time pushing down on it, and you use your thumb and your hand together, like so, you've now made this into what would be a normal stake if this was not in it. Now a modification to this could be undercutting. So instead of it being a flat surface, and then let's say your 550 cord or whatever cordage you would take, right, would then fit around that edge. And then that way you could drive this in, hook around this edge, like so, and it would hold your tarp. So, but this would be considered on this side, nothing else in it, just a regular drivable tent peg or tarp stake, and then that way you got yourself a tie down. So now the notches that we've went over so far is a stake, tipping, so you can tip it out to, won't split it on the end. This is a cabin notch, and this is a stake cut for a tie off. Okay. Now the next one we're going to do is going to be a what they call a saddle or a pocket, and it's going to be a U-cut. Now what that's for is so you have another piece of wood, let's say, you're going to want that piece of wood to set down into it. So what happens, like when you put the two together, that'll keep it steady for making your own primitive pack frame, and then you can lash it together. So, but that one's going to be fairly easy. Just take your same stick in any place that you want. We're just going to make a saddle cut, which is going to be a notch, and we'll just do that on both sides. See, I'm turning the wood around, and you notch it out. You don't want to cut all from one side when it comes to this notch, because you'll make it flat. So once you get it down, you can start really smoothing out that notch, and you do it from both sides, making it as round as you can, or to match the other piece of wood. Because what you would do is you'd put this here, and then I'd cut a notch in the opposite piece of wood. You got yourself a nice notch. Now, see that notch? Then if I cut this piece in, see how they would set together? And then that would make that strong. I would lash it and make it strong. And yes, you could use a cabin notch if you wanted to hook it in. It wouldn't be either choice. Doesn't matter. But what's good about this is this also gives you that getting used to being able to cut for your making a spoon. And that'll be something we'll do in the future, of course. It'll be a much bigger piece of wood. You'll dump it all out. Completely different video. So we've covered notching it, peg, cabin, and then this for a pack frame or to lash them together. So if you want to hook them together, you could make a, I don't know, raft or anything you wanted out of it. Just left up to your scale and what you would want. So then there's a V-notch. Now most V-notches are just that. Just pick a spot on your wood and notch it in. And that's going to be if you just want to tie something on together. Like a strap down on your pack. And you want to keep it where it doesn't climb. I've made, with this knife, I've made a Roycroft frame, fishing spear or gig, and carved out a spoon using it and another tool, but I've used this knife quite a bit in a lot of different things. Now the thing about a V-notch is you want to get all the way down to the edge so you got stuff that can bite, but you don't want it to roll out. So always make sure your notch is all the way to the outer edge of your wood, no matter the size that you're using. Okay. Now what this does, it gives you the ability to use your same cordage. Let's say you want to lash a bunch of stuff down to it, which you will. You can tie off toggles on a Roycroft frame and then tie to that. But if you don't have that or want to use that, or you're going to use some kind of suspensioning system, that's what that does. See there? So now it doesn't, because you're all the way in, keeps it to where it's hard to get out on either side once you've strapped it downwards. If I have it here, it can move. Once it's in that groove, it locks point, so it's harder for it to get done. So you could make like a buck saw with it, and you could use that for the buck saw. When you make yours, put it at the top. That would then come down and go in, then go across to the other side. So when you tightened it up with your twist, that would pull the sides out. It would lock and it couldn't creep itself up. So we went over one, two, three, four, five notches. We're going to do one more. And it's going to be kind of a modify of this. And to me, it's the little, a little more of carving for this one. What you're going to do with it is you're going to make a V. I didn't bring nothing to write with, but you're going to make a V. What you're going to end up doing is you're going to go up and then down. I don't know if you can see that very well, but that's going to be our notch guideline. Okay. And all we're going to do is we're going to intersect first. We're going to make a little V notch like this. I'm going to wedge it down in there pretty good because this is going to be what's going to start what I'm doing. And this is going to be for a pot hanger, okay, at camp. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to cut the edges down. This whole thing will be cut out, but we're going to carve this end. So right now it gives me an idea of how far down to go. Now remember, when you're cutting this in, this is left up to you on how big or how heavy your pot bale is, and then that will dictate how deep you'll make one. But I will tell you this, it is important to have the cut down, because once it's on the fire and you get stuff going, and let's say you've got it really boiling, that water's suspended, this is your fire, suspended directly above. The one thing you don't want to do is drop that. You don't want it to pop off of there. Okay, so that's why you gotta really make this one a good one. And this is just the beginning. This is how you get it started. Then we'll go down from there. But this will be all solid when we get done. So now while I'm carving this, I'm gonna go over a couple things with you. This is a beginning stick, something to carve out. They've got others that have, I want to say, 12 or 13 different notches in them. Those I didn't want to overwhelm anybody with, because to be truthful, this is starting out. And what's good about this is it gives you all the notches that you need to begin with, not need total, that you need to begin with. But it's not so overwhelming that you can't do it. Where you're sitting here, you know, you got a stick foot and a half long, you got notches on every end of it and everything else, that's it's going to be something that's going to be a little overwhelming for you. And that's because that's what I learned about, was you can easily get in and be like, oh, this is a little too much, or it's taking a little too long. But and as you can see, I go all the way to the end, and it's kind of countersinking. That's what I want. But that's why we haven't done a advance. So some of the people that's going to watch this is going to be like, well, that's just, you know, the simples. That's good. I'm glad you know them. And that gives you knowledge and power to go out here and be able to do this stuff and never think twice about it. And to all the people that don't, might not have never made one of these or even thought about it, or might not even cared much about it, and then all of a sudden it's interesting to you. This gives you the ability to use your knife and work with it. Because the only way you're going to get better with your equipment and more confident with it is to work with it. So, we're almost done with it. Edge off there so you can see it good. All right, see that? Now your bale, which I didn't bring mine out here, I should have. I'm sorry I failed you on that one. But your bale, if this is your wire, and you can just hook it, pick it up, and then on the opposite end up here, so where this hook would be up at this area, you would have another hook section that would hook over what you are suspending it over the fire with. And then that way you can pick this up. You'll have a series of notches in it. It'd be the opposite of this. And that way you can raise it on, up and down on the fire for different cooking scenarios. So, but that, as you can see, doesn't have the ability to come over, but yet it's still rounded out to the corners. So your pot can hang off of it. And if you imagine your pot, you're gonna have to come really far before that pot would come out. So that downward force of all the weight that would be in that pot while you're moving it is a lot. And always notice another little trick to do when you're going to cook, look where this is. So if you have to pull anything out, pull it to the cut end. So always keep it to the inside. Don't pull it to the part to where the hook is. So keep it from the non-cut end. So that way if this was the pot, I would then lean more this direction to stir and do all my stuff with it. So then when it's set and hung, we'll do this. Okay, so, and I've got one more for you. So we've got the steak itself, steak cut here, cabin notch, dip, your V knot. We're gonna do one more. Now this one, a lot of people don't do. A lot of people don't practice it or do anything with it. And sometimes, to be totally honest with you, they don't even think about it. But I've used it because that's when you make your bow saw, you gotta have a hole going all the way through, and this has an awl on it. Okay, so what's good about an awl, of course, you're not going to just wedge this in and start going. That's not the way the tool itself is designed. Okay, what I end up doing is taking one of my blades, and I'll make a little cut out, of course, and that gets me started where I want to be. I'm using the smaller blade here just because I'm going to be doing a finer cut to get started in this area. All right, but you don't want a whole lot out of it. You're not going to make a V-notch like this. I'm just making a more of a flat area, and that'll keep my awl from traveling around. And then I can take that and put it in the center, turn it a little bit, and to get that started. That way I'm not skipping off the wood any. You can see right now I've got that getting started pretty good. See that? Now, we're going to get out the awl and go in that same spot. You're just going to put that awl between your fingers like that. Now remember, see how it moves? It's designed that way. You don't want it to go this way. That's the way that closes. You want to keep it between your fingers so when you push down, it's going the opposite direction. And you want to wiggle it in a little and then turn it. And do, just keep doing that. See that? And you just keep doing that around. This part, this is going to be, that's why I saved it to last. This is the one that's going to take the most, okay? A lot of the most effort, one. But two, takes the most time. You can see right now, that hole is starting to burrow through. Now, am I going to make it all the way through? I should make the tip, see that? That's what I should have showed you at the first of it, is that when you go through, make sure you can go all the way in. If not, you just start from the opposite side and get about where you roughly are going to be. Remember, you're not doing anything specific here as far as having to be so precise with where the hole is. But this is if you want to make a lanyard hook, if you want to make a tie, like you drive this stake in. If this was just a stake this size and I wanted to keep the stake, draw the hole into it, put a piece of string through it so you can pull it back out, that kind of stuff. So, but then we just keep doing that, turning it and pushing at the same time, and you can see it's burrowing a hole into it. And then once it comes out that other end, then you'll start on the other side. That way it gives you a guide. And I can hear it cutting in there. Now, something you don't want to do before going any further, don't do this once you start getting it in. Put it down on a piece of wood. All right. Don't get frustrated and want to drive it through or anything like that. Remember, this is it. If you were the only thing you had on you was this knife, and you could do a lot of this. See, there, we're coming out on the other end. Now we know where the hole is. Spin it around five or six good times, and that'll smooth and end up that hole. Then you go to the other side where that hole was, and do the same thing over again. Now you don't have to put a notch in it because you have a hole to go by. Now, once that's all in and done, we'll take our knife here and clean up that edge a little. And you have yourself a hole. So around each side. I don't know if it's got enough stuff in it or not, but I might be able to get that pushed down into it. Give you an idea of what it looks like when it's done. Didn't take that long, but now I want, this is my challenge for everybody. This is what I want you to do. I want you to make this and then show everybody what you can do. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. And I'm going to let you sit here for a minute and take a look at every cut that we've made. You've been here from beginning to end. It can be any scrap piece of wood that you want. That's my challenge to you, okay? You can do this in your living room, at your kitchen table, out on the porch, out in the yard like I just did. And all it takes is a scrap piece of wood, nothing special. And whatever knife you use, if you don't have a saw in your knife, improvise. You can get a buck saw, you can get your Laplander, you know? You can do it with your regular fixed blade knife, you've seen it. And I want you to show me that you can do it. Okay. All right, guys. Well, I hope you learned something off of this. I appreciate it. I'm going to show this through here. Later on, I'm going to do a video that this is going to be very important. I'm going to make a trap using this as a trigger, just so you know. That's a little teaser for later on. All right, guys. You take care of yourself. Get out there and do this. And remember, knowledge doesn't weigh anything. The more you know, the less you take with you. All right, guys, you take care of yourself.